desirable effects. These effects will be overcome but, in the interim of adjustment, whilst they are registering and expressing themselves, there will be much distress, physical and psychological, and all the major and minor difficulties to which humanity seems heir. In undeveloped humanity, the conflict from the angle of consciousness is practically nil. You have less susceptibility to the subtle diseases emanating from the free interlocking system, but at the same time a much greater responsiveness to the three indigenous diseases, to infectious and contagious diseases, and to the great epidemics which sweep through nations and great planetary areas. As humanity develops, diseases become more personal, if I might express it in this manner, and are not so definitely related to the third or mass condition. They arise within the persons themselves, and though they may be related to the mass diseases, they are based on individual causes. When a man steps out of the general mass and steps upon the probationary path, and thus becomes a candidate for discipleship, then the diseases of the flesh and the economy of his entire threefold system, plus the conveying stream, constitute a conscious problem and one which the aspirant must himself tackle, thus revealing to him the need for conscious, creative building. It is at this point that the doctrine of reincarnation becomes its supreme value. The disciple begins to institute those conditions, to create those forms and build those vehicles which, in another life, will prove more suitable for soul control and more adequate instruments with which to carry forward the perfecting process with the soul demands. Let me point out that the disciple does not concentrate upon the physical body at any time, or begin with any physical emphasis the work of the illumination of disease or disharmony. He begins with the psychology which the soul teaches and commences with the causes which are producing the effects upon the physical plane. It is a slower process, but endures. Much of the violent auto-suggestion of the citizens allied to Christian Science and Unity are only temporary in their effects and are based upon a process of scientific suppression, plus a refusal to recognize existing factors. They are not based on truth. In a later life, the suppressed condition will again emerge in ever greater potency and will continue to occur until such time as it is ignored altogether and the life emphasis is laid on soul contact and the life expression is excavated into service to others. In connection with physical disease and liberation to the senders regarding these appropriate points. Copyright 1998 Rules of Trust. 117, A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. For incoming energies from some source or another, it might be useful if certain broad generalizations were made here, remembering that to all of these there may be exceptions, particularly in the case of the health or the non-health of disciples. 1. Each of the seven major centers governs their conditions, from the material angle as well as from that of the soul and of the life principles, in area of the physical body in which it is found, including the multitude of lesser centers of energy and plexus forces may be found therein. 2. The three great bases and manifesting divisions of divinity are to be found symbolically present in every center. The life principle, the first aspect, discloses itself when the entire center is esoterically unfolded or awakened. It is present all the time in latency, but it is not a dynamic factor producing monadic stimulation in this belief is a consequent effect upon the surrounding tissue, substance and organic forms within the radius of influence of the center. The area of this influence is variable according to the activity of the center, and this is dependent upon the kind of development reached by the individual and the preponderant type of energy to which the individual reacts. 3. The incoming energy is transmitted within the center into forces. This involves a process of differentiation into secondary energy with the primary energy involved, and is an automatic happening. The rate of transmutation process, the strength of the resultant aggregation of forces, and the subsequent radiator reactivity producing conditioning results upon the dense physical body are dependent upon the extent of the unfoldment of the particular center involved in its awakened or unawakened state. 4. The outgoing forces from the center play upon the apparent counterpart of the entire intricate network of nerves which constitute the nervous system. Counterparts of identical subjective correspondences are called in the Hindu philosophy, deep, they constitute an intricate and most extensive network of fluid energies which are an intangible, interior, paralleling system to that of the bodily nerves, which latter system is in fact an externalization of the inner pattern of energy. Words which give no word in the English language or in any European. Copyright 1998 Newfoundland. Note 18. The Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. The existence of this subjective system is not yet recognized, and only the materialistic concept of the nerves of the system built up in response to a tangible environment yet holds sway in the West. The idea of these nerves being the dense physical result of an inner sensitive response apparatus is still undefined and unrecognized by modern Western science. Recognition is afforded to this subtle substance composed of threads of energy underlying the more tangible nerves, we shall have moved forward in our approach to the entire problem of health and disease, and the world of causes will be that much nearer. This network of nadis forms a definite life pattern which varies according to the personality ray. 5. The nadis, therefore, determine the nature and the quality of the nervous system with its extensive network of nerves and plexi covering the entire physical body. The nadis, and consequently the network of nerves, are related primarily to two aspects of man's physical equipment, the seven major centers in the etheric body, the substantial body which underlies the dense physical body, and the spinal column with the head. It must always be remembered that the etheric body is a physical body, both in terms of subtler material than the one we can see in touch. It is made of substance or of that which, substance, or underlies every part and particle of the dense physical vehicle. This is a point which the reader received attention from healers and from enlightened medical men in the New Age. demonstrate that their united externalization is an independent system which corresponds to the form or matter aspect. These three, the naive, the nervous system and the gland, are the material correspondences to the three divine aspects. They are esoterically responsive to these three aspects and they make the man upon the physical plane what he is. Themselves conditioned through the seven centers, as we have earlier seen by the astral and mental vehicle, or by the integrated personality, or by the soul that begins to use the personality of the transmitting and transmuting agency, and, as it goes to the path of discipleship, by the monad, via the antagrana, using that self-created path as a direct channel of communication to the seven centers and from there to the threefold system of nadi, nerves and glands. 7. These three major systems within the human being express through the medium of the physical body the condition of the state of development of the centers. The life, the quality and the energy which they represent are conveyed to every part of the physical vehicle via the bloodstream. This, modern science has already recognized in the past, indicating that the bloodstream conveys. Copyright 1998 Basic Trust. 119, The Creed Upon the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. 30 elements released by the plan. This is not yet recognized as that of the relationship of the plans to the center, but the intermediate surface is not even familiar. The next great move in medicine will be to recognize the fact of the apparent body, the physical substance which underlies this matter. 8. When the centers are awakened throughout the body, there will then be the presence of highly electric nervous system, responsive to the immediacy to the energy carried by the nadi. The result of this will be a well-balanced endocrine system. The vitality and life-storing through the entire body will then be a sub-potency that automatically the physical body will be resistant to disease. In these words I express for you a future probability but not an immediate possibility. Man will someday have the three systems perfectly coordinated, psychically responsive to the inner pattern of not being centered, and consciously integrated with the soul, and later, via the antaprana, with the life principle. Today as there is uneven development, with some centers unawakened, others overstimulated, and with the centers below.